Thank you very much. Good morning. My name is Nipit Wongpanya, and the chairperson of the Master of Arts in Business and Management Economics, or MABE program. The world is changing faster than ever before. To adapt to a rapidly changing world, the fundamental alignment between business and economics is needed. With nearly 20 years experience, so our program provides students with a firm understanding of core business and economic theories at the same time, providing the practical skills that are essential to applying business and economics reasoning in our increasingly changing world. Then why our program, right? So highly qualified lecturers from both academic and professionals in various fields from several domestic and foreign universities, and courses that provide necessary knowledge in both economics and business management topics, regularly updated to reflect rapid changes in economics and business environment, right, in both domestic and global scale, right? MABE provides a flexible program structure. So we offer full-time programs and part-time programs. And this outline of the present today, we're gonna have a look at program structure, student activities, and important notes for students. These program structures, we can look at the core and elective courses, program structure, study plan, and the options on thesis and non-thesis options, right? And for full time, 1 year. So we got 1 year full time programs. Have 3 terms. 36 credits. For thesis, core courses, so we have 8 core courses, total 24 credits. For non-thesis students, 8 courses, 24 credits. And for non-thesis, students must take elective courses, 3 courses, or 9 credits. And then individual study, 1 course or 3 credits. For thesis students, they have to take 8 courses, 8 core courses, and past thesis, in total for thesis 12 credits. And for part-time programs, that would be 2 years, 2 years, 6 terms, and again, in total 36 credits. Have a look at full-time thesis options. So the first terms, take 4 core courses. Second term, 3 core courses and 1 elective course. And the third term, students focus on thesis. That would be 12 credits. And 1 course might have to be taken if necessary for the students. For full-time non-thesis option, first term, 4 core courses. Second term, 3 core courses and 1 elective course. For the third term, students take 1 core course, 2 elective courses, and, students have must do individual study and then take the comprehensive exam. This is the for part-time, right? Part-time students, part-time programs, part-time thesis option. So 2 years programs, so first year and second year. So first year, first term, actually the whole year, the first year take 6 core courses, right? And then second year, first term, take 1 core course, second term, another 1 core course, and third term, take a thesis. And for part-time non-thesis option, right, part-time non-thesis option, first term, second term, the third term in the first years, take 6 core courses. And the second years, first term, second term, take 1 core course, 1 elective course, another 1 core course, and then take individual study. And the third term, right, take 2 elective courses plus student must pass the comprehensive exam. Right, so let's look at the our core courses provided for the students. And so we got advanced Academic Theory 1 is microeconomics, advanced microeconomics, and advanced economic theory 2, that would be the advanced in macroeconomics and quantitative methods and economic analysis. So this is the like econometrics. And then we have cost and financial analysis, economics of production and marketing, economics of human resource management, money and finance, financial management in economic development, economics of international business management. You can see that we have the mix, you know, between economics and business field. Again, core courses, you know, 8 core courses in total, 24 credits. Right? And this is our elective courses that offer to our students. Students can choose research method and workshop in business and managerial economics, project evaluation, project feasibility analysis, economics of risk management, international financial and investment theory, entrepreneurial strategic management, and management consulting or game theory, and managerial application. And yeah, this is some of our invited lecturers, you know, from across the world, from Italy, from Singapore, from Switzerland, right? From Thailand, from Germany. Yeah, so this is an example of some of our invited lecturers. For the thesis option, what student must to do, right? Student find the topic, notify the office, MAB office, MAB assigned supervisors and committees, and then register in CUI thesis website, prepare and defend the thesis proposal, make a presentation at a seminar, prepare and defend the thesis, and then finalize the thesis and upload to the IA thesis website. Yeah. And then for non-thesis option, student must do individual study. So this is the a group of research focusing on selected business firms. This is compulsory, right? Students must participate in all academic activities throughout the trip. We're gonna take the student to do the field trip to visit the firms, either in domestic firms or overseas firms, and then student come back and to write the report, individual study. And this example, this is individual study for full-time domestic field trip. And we went to, many places, many provinces, across country, across Thailand. This is some of the examples of the individual studies. So then we divide students into the groups and, one firm per group, and then students come back and write individual study, write the research about the firms they visited. And yeah, this again another examples of pictures for overseas field trip. We went to Italy, Switzerland, Germany, England, in Japan, many places, around the world. And then again, students select the firms, right, and come back and write the research about the firms, right? This is for part-time, right, domestic field trip in part-time. This is in Thailand, right, domestic field trip. And this is the overseas field trip example for part-time students. And yeah, if students decide to do non-thesis option, they compulsory they have to do individual studies and come back and write the research about the firms they visited. So either domestic or foreign or overseas firms. And then they have to pass the comprehensive exam, right? And the comprehensive exams composed of two steps. So one, student must pass written examinations. And after they pass written examination, they have to pass oral examinations. So a lot of work after, come back from the field trip and write the research on about the firms, and they must pass the comprehensive exams as well, right? And this is just the activities of our student. We have the first and the last orientation. This is the activity before the COVID-19 pandemic. After the, after 2019, all activities has been canceled, and we hopefully we're gonna resume our student activities again, hopefully this academic year. And yeah, this is just the some of the pictures of the first and the last first and the last orientation. We've got a sport day, right? Sport days. We have the activity among students in Faculty of Economics in other programs, other master programs. To get together, to know each other, to share, right? Knowledge with each other, and they get together party, right? Right after they finish. With other programs in our faculties, yes, we have get together party for them to congratulate them, right? And yes, we have the special lectures every year. Our programs during November, special lectures. We have a cooperation with Nomura Securities, and every year during in November, so we have the special lectures. And last November, again, since we have the COVID-19 situation was not stable yet, then we decided to have the special lectures again with Nomura Securities. The guest speakers, are from Nomura Securities, but they were not in the same place. One in Japan, one in Singapore, right? One in Hong Kong, and then with the online, then we can okay. So with the technology, we can have the special lectures, even though guest speakers they're not in the same place. And this is the special lectures online session for our program. And so we have a support and facilities, library resources. It is all the JULA's facilities, right, to support students. Electronic journals, database, and students can do some research on, looking for the information, the previous research, right, to help them to do research. So either thesis or non-thesis, or individual studies. Then so we have internet access. Then we've got economic documentation and information center. There's important notes for students. The application period. So we have three application periods. Student can submit the applications. The first round from February 1st to March 13th. Second round, March 14th to April 17th. And then the third round, April 18th to May 15th, right? And then we're gonna announce the results, final results in June 3rd, we have the first meeting with the students to introduce the program to the students, welcome students in June the 5th. So this is important because all the course taught entirely in English, then English proficiency test is important. So applicants who have not fulfilled an English proficiency requirements are required to take an English proficiency test, and get at least a minimum score, right, as announced by the program. Right? And then students could take the UTEP, TOEFL, paper-based, internet-based, or IELTS, and intensive courses, because we are aware that our students come from different backgrounds, then we strongly recommend that students could take our intensive courses, right, to have enough, sufficient knowledge before get to the core courses or to the program. Right, the applicants who do not have strong background in economics and or econometrics are strongly advised to take appropriate intensive courses, and we offer three intensive courses, right? One, Introduction to Econometrics, Microeconomics, and Macroeconomics. Yeah, the details for intensive course, the student can have a look at the link below. And again, for foreign applicants visa application, foreign applicants outside Thailand, the university now requires a proof of COVID-19 vaccination from foreign applications before they can come to study in our university. Consequently, a foreign application must submit such a proof to our MABE program for approval before a visa application documents will be issued. And it is again for foreign applicants that already in Thailand. Applicants who just finished their study in Thailand must contact the International Affairs Office, Faculty of Economics, right? And for detail on how to extend student visa to continue student study at Chulalongkorn University. And the details is on the web website, yeah, as below. Right, then the first term, yeah, study this year. Hopefully, we're gonna have the on-site. Then we put on-site lecture. Then the MABE's first classes will begin at very early August 2022. And then a study in the first term, we put in the schedule that we're gonna have the on-site. Yeah, on-site. Yeah, we have the lecture in campus. This contact, right? Contract. We have a look at the contract. Address again, Faculty of Academics, Chulalongkorn University. Yes, yeah, so email. Yeah, student can email to mabe@jula.ac.th. Right. Student could visit our website and Facebook as well. Yeah, thank you very much.